What is up, everybody? Welcome back to another This Week in Gaming video. Let's get you caught up on some of the events that have gone on in the past week in gaming. Over the last few months, one of the big topics between the different gaming platforms has been crossplay. Microsoft wanting to crossplay with Sony and vice versa, Sony not reciprocating that. They are not wanting to crossplay whatsoever, but Microsoft has really been out there and saying to everybody that they believe that the best way to go forward with gaming is for everybody to be able to play together. They already crossplay with the Nintendo Switch and with PC, but Sony just won't open up their avenue in order to crossplay with the Xbox. The CEO of Sony, Kenchiro Yoshida, believes that PlayStation is the best place to play, which is why they won't have any crossplay specifically with Fortnite. Here's exactly what Kenchiro Yoshida had to say. On cross-platform, our way of thinking is always that PlayStation is the best place to play. Fortnite, I believe, partnered with PlayStation 4, is the best experience for the user. That's our belief. But actually, we already opened up some games to cross-platform with PC and some others, so we decide based on what is the best user experience. That is our way of thinking for cross-platform. Now, many of the headlines were coming out saying that Sony is the best place to play, is the only reason why they won't do Fortnite, because they just think they're so good and so much better than everybody else. Well, he's sort of saying that. Well, okay, I guess he is saying that, especially with Fortnite, because he does not want to cross-platform with other consoles. And they have a huge user base of Fortnite on the PlayStation 4, but obviously PC is the biggest. But what he's really saying is that they will look to other options for crossplay, just not with the Xbox. They'll do it with PC if it's a good for the user experience, but at the end of the day, they're not going to do it with the Xbox One or with any Microsoft consoles coming out in the future. Now, the only thing I can think of as to why they're doing this still, and they're still harping on not wanting any crossplay, even though other platforms, Nintendo, Microsoft, and PC are all open to it, is because they have such a big lead right now in the current generation of markets that they don't want those numbers to be skewed, and they want to end this generation by being the best-selling platform. Now, I know the Xbox One didn't really have a great start, but if you look at what they've been doing in the last little while with all of the decisions that they have been making, which I think have all been really, really good, specifically with the Xbox Game Pass, which I think is an amazing deal and amazing value. I personally think that the Xbox One UI is much better than the PlayStation 4's, and the overall experience on Xbox Live, I think, is better, especially just with the console and the way everything works and being able to message people and just all of that all integrated into one. I think it's just a better platform than the PlayStation 4. And then obviously their crossplay is good. I mean, they crossplay with Nintendo, they want to crossplay with the PlayStation 4, they crossplay with PC, and they have the Xbox Play Anywhere, so you can get a game and play it on the PC or play it on the Xbox. And they're really opening their minds that they don't want everyone just coming to the Xbox to play on that console. What they are understanding is to win now in the future, it's going to be software sales and services that are going to make you king of the video game world, which they have started with the Xbox Game Pass, and we'll see more of this obviously in the future. But overall, I mean, it doesn't really make much sense for the consumer, for the PlayStation 4. I mean, me personally, I play the majority of my games on the Xbox One X. I absolutely love the console. It is more powerful than the PlayStation 4 Pro, and I just like playing all my multi-platform games on that system. I only really use my PlayStation 4 for the exclusives. That's pretty much it. But if I had to pick one console to keep at the end of the day, I probably would pick the Xbox One X just because I use it more and I play tons of multi-platform games. And then I would just borrow a PlayStation 4 when I want to play the exclusives. Those are just my thoughts on this matter. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. And if you think this is a terrible move by Sony, or if you think they are smart by protecting their console, not trying to get people to play with other consoles and potentially losing those customers to the other console because of the crossplay. Call of Duty Black Ops 4 is just around the corner, and they have now shown off the Blackout map, which is their battle royale mode for Call of Duty Black Ops 4. And this map is pretty big. It has 13 locations, and these locations are Turbine, Factory, Cargo Docks, Fracking Tower, Nuketown Island, Array, Firing Range, Rivertown, Asylum, Hydro Dam, Train Station, Construction Site, and Estates. Now, this is just a big mixture of the Black Ops universe onto this one huge map, and they have also announced that there will be zombies featured in this game mode. And like they've shown off in their previous trailers and in the newest trailer they just released, is that you will be able to traverse this entire map in the air on water or on the ground in a vehicle or by foot. And honestly, this, when I saw this new trailer, I got really hyped for it. I'm really excited to see what this is all about, and I know the beta is just around the corner and we'll get a lot more from the beta on how this blackout mode will really be at the end of the day. And I'm really excited just to see more about it, play this blackout mode, play the beta, and if it's good, for the final game to come out. So for a while now, there has been lots of talk about esports coming into the Olympics and people debating whether it should be in the Olympics or it shouldn't be, whether the skills used in esports are good enough to become an Olympic sport. Well, it looks like this can all pretty much be put to rest and that esports won't be coming to the Olympics, because Thomas Bach, the ICC president, commented on esports, and here's what he said. "We cannot have in the Olympic program a game which is promoting violence or discrimination. They, from our point of view, are contradictory to the Olympic values and cannot therefore be accepted." Now, I'm not totally surprised that this came out now, because this came out after the Madden tournament shooting, which obviously was a terrible, tragic event that was extremely violent. So he's obviously looking at that and saying, well, we can't have something where an event like that occurred in the Olympics. Let me know in the comments below what you think about this. If you think Thomas Bach is correct that it shouldn't be in the Olympics, or if you think that it should be in the Olympics and you would love to see it in the Olympics in the future. So THQ keeps going out and acquiring different IPs, lots of big name things, and they have just gone out and acquired the IP for Kingdom of Amalur, which comes from 38 Studios that filed for bankruptcy. And when this game was released, it got mixed with pretty good scores across the board. It had some polarizing opinions, but overall it was a pretty decent game, and it was an action hack and slash RPG style of a game. And it's crazy that THQ is making this huge comeback acquiring all these titles. If you remember back in February, they acquired Koch Media, which includes games now like TimeSplitters, Saints Row, and Metro. And these are all popular games that have a lot of familiarity with gamers. So when they release new versions of these games, I think they'll have a really good reception. And I'm excited to see how THQ handles these titles and how well they make these games. So that's news. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that thumbs up button, subscribe if you're new to this channel, leave a comment down below about any of the things I talked about, and I'll catch you in the next video.